Hello, Neha.
Hi, Tanya.
It was a very hectic day of school today.
Absolutely.
Neha, did you register yourself for the upcoming inter-school sports meet?
Yes, I did. What about you?
Actually, I was not able to make up my mind for it.
Why? What is the matter, dear?
Our school sports captain had suggested me to get enrolled for badminton instead of tennis.
Why would she say that?
She said that badminton is a more popular and promising game for girls.
What? What does that mean?
I don't know, but last year also, many girls from our school were selected for zonal and national tournaments for badminton and none for tennis. So I'm also thinking that what she said may be right.
Oh dear, don't be foolish and don't get influenced by such fake suggestions and thoughts. I know who can help you.
Who?
My cousin's sister. She is a very good tennis player and had recently won a trophy for her college.
Is it? Wow! So what are we waiting for, Neha? Let's go!
Hello, Minindi. How are you?
Hello, Neha. I'm good. How are you?
I'm also good, Dee. Meet my friend, Tanya.
Hello, Tanya. How are you?
I'm fine, Dee. How are you?
Very well.
Dee, Tanya wants to play tennis, but due to some vague thoughts, she is not able to make up her mind for the upcoming inter-school sports meet.
Oh, why is it so?
Everybody is suggesting me that badminton is a more popular and promising sport for girls. So I'm in a fix what to do.
Oh dear, it's not like that. In fact, tennis is also a very promising and a very popular sport for girls. And we have so many inspiring women who has actually crossed all the hurdles and reached at the top of the sport.
Is it, Dee?
Yes, exactly. In fact, let me tell you about a girl who just like you aspired to be a tennis player. And she faced all sorts of confusions and hurdles. But finally, her unwavering desire to succeed and her desire to resolve all the sacrifices helped her to win many titles and hearts altogether.
Really? Who is she, Dee? Dee, please tell me about her.
Of course. A very determined and aspiring girl from Russia who gave wings to her aspiration, Maria was born on 19th April 1987. You know, Tanya, Maria got her first tennis racket when she was just 4 years old. And that also from the father of the Grand Slam winner, Yevgeny Kafelnikov. You know, at the age of 6, Maria attended a tennis clinic in Moscow, which was run by Martina Navratilova. And there, Navratilova, she actually recognizes her talent and recommended her to attend a training session in Florida, USA.
Wow!
You know, in 1994, she moved from Russia to United States of America with her father to get herself enrolled at Nick Bollettieri's Tennis Academy. And unfortunately, her mother couldn't join them in Florida because her visa was not cleared. But later, she joined them after 2 years.
Really, Dee? She left her home and mother for tennis? How did she manage with all that?
Yes, indeed. She sacrificed everything for her passion. But despite her sacrifices, she was not given immediate admission at the Nick Bollettieri's Academy because she was too young to be in the academy. But she didn't stop dreaming. She initially took her tennis training at Rick Messi Tennis Academy and later she signed a deal with International Management Group, a global sports and talent organization based in New York. Maria recalled, "I used to be so lonely. I missed my mother terribly. My father was working as much as he could to keep my tennis training going. So, he couldn't see me either. Because I was so young, I used to go to bed at 8 p.m. The other tennis pupils would come in and at 11 p.m. and wake me up and order me to tidy up the room and clean it. Instead of letting that depress me, I became more quietly determined and mentally tough. I learned how to take care of myself. I never thought of quitting because I knew what I wanted. When you come from nothing and you have nothing, then it makes you very hungry and determined. I would have put up with much more humiliation and insults than that to steadfastly pursue my dream.
Oh my God, what a brave and determined girl. She was so clear what to want and how to get it. Great day.
Very true, Tanya. While her journey from the frozen plains of Siberia to the summit of women's tennis, she has won the hearts of millions of tennis fans. But for herself, there was no space for such emotions and sentiments in her heart. The straight looks and the answer she gives when asked about her ambition gives a clear picture that how much she values her sacrifices. I'm very, very competitive. I work hard at what I do. It's my job.
Oh, this is her mantra for success.
Yes, Tanya. Apart from being a dedicated tennis player, she's also a true patriot. She believes although US has a huge contribution in her tennis career, but still she'll be preferring to be called a player from Russia, her birthplace. In her words, I'm Russian. It's true that the US is a big part of my life, but I have Russian citizenship. My blood is totally Russian. I will play the Olympics for Russia if they want me.
But Dee, from all that what you told me, I think she is not just like a common teenager who has only one aspiration and only one thing in life, that is tennis.
No, Neha, it's not like that. Just like any other common teenager, she also bears hobbies like fashion, dancing and singing. She loves to read Arthur Conan Doyle. Her fondness for sophisticated evening gowns appears at odds with her love for pancakes with chocolate spread and frizzy orange drinks.
Oh, really?
Yes. But you know, not only that, few people also have grudge for her riches, which she is now reaping. But you know, what she has to say about it? Of course, money is a motivation. Tennis is a business and a sport. But the most important thing is to become a number one in the world. That is the dream that kept me going. So Tanya, now tell me, what do you think about Maria Sharapova now?
Thanks, Minidi. Because of you today, I got to know about such a strong and determined girl, Maria Sharapova, who cannot be pigeonholed or categorized. The things which helped her to reach at the top of the world are her talent, her unwavering desire to succeed and readiness to sacrifice.
Very good. I'm proud of you.
All right. Now you tell me, Tanya, which will you take for the inter-school sports meet? Badminton or tennis?
Obviously, tennis.